Bradley Brooks nimmt es auf mit der aktuellen Nummer 8 der Welt. Er steht inzwischen bei 9 Major-Titeln. Hat auch das Jahr 2019 bislang klasse absolviert, schon 3 Erfolge auf der Pro Tour feiern können. Und den kennt ihr wirklich alle. The Machine, James Way! Match Nummer 3 bedeutet, wir haben unseren zweiten Caller auf der Bühne, George Noble.
Well, 2 seeded players safely through to the final day of action. The ferret, Johnny Clayton, joining Chizzy Dave Chisnell in the last 16 of the European Darts match play. In the few weeks preceding this tournament, there's something called the Champion of Champions, old news of the world rules, best of 3 legs, cutthroat stuff. And every single year, it seems players who do well in that tournament, make the final, go on and win it, then have a boost and carry on playing some decent stuff in the weeks that follow. Bradley Brooks, young man from Lancashire, made it to the final, only lost out to Jim Williams in the BDO. And finds himself on the European Tour for the first time in his fledgling career. He picked up a win against Mark McGeaney, defying an average of more than 101 from the former BDO number one. And now takes on James Wade.
Bradley to throw first. Game on.
Is Bradley Brooks going to demonstrate the post-Champion of Champions boost? And knock out a former winner of the European Darts match play. James Wade was the winner back in 2016, in the first year it was held in Hamburg. Paul Nicholson's alongside me to find out.
Thanks, Dan. Yeah, it'd be interesting to see how Bradley copes with this task here. A lot more fans here today. It was a great performance yesterday from Brad. He'll be full of beans now.
440.
But one thing I know about Wadey, more than anything else, is that when he plays someone for the first time, he likes to put down a marker for future games against said opponent. So he's never played Brad before, and he's very young, and he might remind him of a very young Wadey. So he will want to do a job today that will make him focused.
Well, Bradley has been on the full tour for a long while at all. He only got his tour card at the start of last year. He's currently ranked just inside the top 90. So if he is going to avoid having to go back to Q school, he's going to have to do something. And that's not bad, is it? Bradley Brooks, 171 to leave himself double 18.
I think the one thing that Brad has got in his favour more than anything else today is that he is going to be more practiced than James.
44. Bradley requires
James had last week off. Brad practices in his sleep. And a very good start from Bam Bam. We said yesterday, Dan, didn't we, that Bam Bam, he doesn't weigh as much as his darts.
Yes.
He actually resembles the width of the Bam Bam club used in the Flintstones. We love him, though. He's a great young kid. And his attitude is second to none. He's passionate. But he's not arrogant or flashy with it, he just wants to get up there and play.
Yeah, we've seen him at the UK Open this year and last year. Big stage darts have been very few opportunities for Bradley Brooks. Not been on the Euro Tour, not played any of the other major tournaments as yet. So he's still, this is all very, very new. And I think at the UK Open, he'll have only played on the outside boards or in Red Spa, the second stage. So this is probably the biggest crowd he's played in front of. Because he can only get a few hundred in that second stage in Minehead. I don't know how many we've got here. You can't even see to the back of this crowd, can you? But I would imagine we've probably got a couple of thousand.
Standard Saturday afternoon in Germany.
Well, this is what he wants to be doing. Wants to be playing stage darts against the biggest names and a first ever meeting against
140.
Yeah, a genuine legend of the game in James Wade. Something to savour for Bradley. He wants to give a good account of himself, and at the minute he's certainly doing that.
140. James Wade, 38.
Straight for it. No hesitation. And why do you need hesitation when you've got that left arm? This could be a really good tussle, this. I remember what Weirdy was like when he was 17 or 18.
Thinner?
96.
Yeah. And he didn't wear that shirt either. Now, I'd love to get the Twitter sphere involved in this, because when you think about
100,
the top 32 players in the world, they all love a new shirt when it comes to a new season. Weirdy's been wearing that one now, by my calculation, 10 years.
Yeah, the only difference is, what was it, two or three years ago, he put the number plate on the back?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Same shirt, same material, probably the same size.
Not sure about that.
85.
That's why I said probably. But he's obviously got an affiliation with that fabric and that colour, because it hasn't changed. And if you think about most of the guys, even Van Gerwen's changed his a little bit.
58.
But I think he's one of the only people in the top 32 that doesn't change. Whitlock's the other one.
You know, he'll change his trousers and his shoes more readily than he will his shirt, won't he, Wade?
Have you heard his rule on dart shoes?
What is his rule?
The rule for dart shoes, Wade says, is that they're not good enough unless they cost at least 200 quid.
Yeah, well, I mean, you know. All right. Ivory Tower, Wadey. It's all right when you're European champion and World Series champion and hoovering up money left, right and centre.
100.
I know the brand he wears. I'm not allowed to say on the air, though. They're quite nice. They're not my cup of tea. But then again, I've been wearing some very loud shirts the last couple of weeks.
Yeah, I think you just keep it reserved.
100.
Bradley Brooks leaves himself on double 10 and... Bradley will be feeling quite happy. He'll be Scott, hold me and throw it. I'm giving James Wade a game. I'm playing some decent stuff. But I would think Bradley will be quite aware
15.
That Wadey can strike from positions like this.
Can't leave him on 112. He just can't. Something like 104, 105, 112. This is what he does. And it was just predictable.
Bradley Brooks.
Full flag, James.
This is James Wade. That is wading. Give him a sniff. And it's just gone.
It's just 60 single tops.
Very, very
I would
simple.
Love to know how many times 60. He's done it in his career.
Yeah, it's... And it, look, that's a leg where he wasn't... He was always second best all the way through that leg.
100.
And then, oh, three misses. Thank you very much. I love that leg. And that may well be the difference. James Wade may just hold throw four times, not even challenge on Bradley Brooks' throw for the rest of the match.
38.
A couple of years ago, or maybe even 18 months ago, James started doing something when he was throwing that was detrimental to his 60. Action. Now, if you look at his left heel, which is his lead heel, it's coming off the ground. It's not as bad as it was.
No, it was very pronounced, wasn't it? And he...
140.
He went through a spell where he said, I know what I'm doing, I don't need to change anything, I'm a multiple major champion. And then he did seek some advice. He was
59.
Talking to Eric Bristow for a while. I think he spoke to Rod Harrington. And then he did iron it out, and lo and behold, James
99.
Wade started winning things again, and big things. European Championship and World Series Finals both claimed last year within a week of each other. One of the best weeks of James Wade's career. As Bradley Brooks piles in a 180. Fighting back the young man. But James Wade wants treble 18. Oh, hoo, hoo.
98. Bradley
can Bradley do a weird to weird? Might stay there. It was the right call. It's only just off. Wadey will be looking at 14s here. Straight up north for 12s. Six is good. Boy, that looked good. That looked sharp.
Yeah. His last start in hand and has to go. James Wade's one of the go-to guys you want. Even if he is just letting that little bad habit of hopping up on his front foot creep in. Nathan Aspinall does it a lot. Nathan Aspinall doesn't seem to... It's been part of his game forever. But James, who was always stock still, and the reason he was doing it was because he felt that he was consistently low on his first start. He was losing his height. Now, you talked about this yesterday as a technical thing, where...
100.
It doesn't necessarily... Just because you're losing height in your dart doesn't mean you just have to go and stand on a chair and throw from higher. It's about how you're throwing it, where you're releasing it. That's the issue. You've got no problem from 8 feet away of getting it up to double top if you want. It's just how you are throwing it.
That's right. And James had a definitive address position in the earlier part of his career. If you look at it from an action replay, say 10 years ago when he won the match play, just over 10 years ago. So what it was like maybe 18 months ago, the address position was so much higher. So he was throwing the dart and it was coming out of his hand later. He was told about it. So he started to bring the address position down again, in line with what he used to do. His game changed immediately. Now, that kind of change, it takes some conscious practice over the course of a couple of months to make it natural again. And then what did he go and do? He started to win tournaments on the floor, and then he won stuff on TV. And he's back in the Premier League.
Oh, I like this, Bradley Brooks. Double 10.
Oh, hello! Bam Bam with a bit of aggression. I wasn't expecting that. Well, you can't blame him because he's a young lad and he wants this. Why not? And that was very Bam Bam like. What I want him to do is when he hits a double like that, to say Bam Bam. I wonder where he got his nickname from. And here comes the adrenaline. He nearly gets the maximum.
Well, Wadey, who is not averse to a little bit of aggression himself.
60.
He wouldn't possibly.
I don't think he's not going to bite like this. James seems to get it into his head at times that an opponent needs to
100.
Have some aggression thrown at them. He's done it a couple of times where he's mentioned that. But most of the time he doesn't engage, does he? He just goes about his business.
He times it well.
136.
And I remember playing him in the 2011 UK Open quarterfinals, and the timing of one of his celebrations, it was right in my face, but it was perfectly done because it hurt. The shot that he hit really hurt, and he wanted to accentuate it. Now, I know what we all talked about at Christmas time with Sega Osada. That's in the history books. What we're all waiting for, potentially, is Sega Osada, James Wade 2, because he's at the Worlds again, isn't he?
He is going to be at the Worlds, and he'll be dangerous. Mark my words.
57.
Bradley leaves himself in a 2-darter. James is already down to 1. Double 12. Oh, standard Wadey stuff, this. The checkouts, 112, 66, 75, all niggly little ones with one treble or no treble. Just got to be neat and tidy, and that's exactly what he's doing. And Bradley Brooks is averaging... Well, look, he beat Mark McGeaney with an average 11 points lower than McGeaney in the first round. Here, he has had an average higher than James Wade for the entirety 100. Of the game. But it does not matter because Wade keeps on pinning those finishes. And when he's gone out, Bradley has been left on finishes himself. Pretty simple ones, 60. 2 darters. But that's what James Wade does. There are times when he seems oblivious to pressure. You can keep piling in big scores and leaving yourself options, and he just carries on as if you were 400 points behind. Yeah, and other players can't do that.
Yeah, when the waitress goes to his breakfast table and they say, Mr. Wade, what would you like for breakfast? He says, pressure.
38.
And a rare week late. It's probably the worst start to a leg. In fact, it is the worst start to a leg Bradley Brooks has had. And James Wade could pinch another break.
58.
And it will end up looking like this has been a comfortable victory if he goes on and wins it 6-2. But it has been anything but, because Bradley Brooks has had a good go at him.
140.
Well, someone else who had a good go at him was Damon Hetter.
Oof.
Now, you could say that Damon Hatter winning the Brisbane Masters was all James's fault, because he's the one who missed a couple of match darts against him in round one. But then again, everything works in circles, doesn't it? Because James Wade has won so many titles in his career where people have missed match darts against him early on. It's not going to happen in this game by the looks of it, because Wade is 5-2 to the good.
Yeah, and it is a great throw. And Bradley Brooks may fear that the game is up. Yeah, James Wade, of course, surviving match darts in the final of the World Series finals against Michael Smith. He also survived match darts in the semi-finals of the European Championship. I mean, he's walked away with two major titles and an enormous amount of money from 100. That week. But it could have been significantly less. We're looking at £150,000 won there in those two events. £100,000 of that was ranking money as well. Now, it would have been £25,000 if he'd lost in the semi-final. So that's £75,000 gone. And it would have been half that 50. It might have been 20, I think, if he'd been beaten by Michael Smith. I mean, we are talking a vast, vast difference in the amount of money he's won there. But if you're going to get your luck in the big ones that matter.
I suppose that's true.
Rob Cross survived many match starts against Michael Van Gerwen in the semi-finals of the World Championship, and he did. Took advantage of it in the final, and it has changed his life.
And he survived match starts against Michael Smith earlier in the tournament as well.
Yes.
But the most interesting thing about last year's European Championships for me, Wade won it and didn't move in the rankings by winning it.
60.
That's probably where the whole rankings discussion started. By winning £100,000 10 years ago, that would have vaulted you up the rankings, something ridiculous, like what Simon Whitlock did in his first world final.
Yeah,
he went up to number 18 overnight from nowhere in the rankings. He was in the 60s or 70s probably, but James Wade stayed where he was.
Well, Bradley Brooks, is he going to take this out? I like the route for that. Staying in the same portion of the board, but that might be the last visit he has, because James Wade, who's been so clinical all the way through this game, does not take out the 97. Can Bradley Brooks get a break back? Keep this game alive?
Keep fighting, Brad. Double three.
21.
Is that the last dart he throws? Well, Wade's on top, so you think it probably will be.
Has to be from there, you'd think. And Wade on double 10.
20.
Well, he's as astonished as anybody. Wow, three. He says.
Looks like he's just seen a ghost. Ghost of doubles past. Hope it's not the ghost of doubles future.
One. James, you require 20.
I don't think Bradley Brooks thought he was going to get another chance. And maybe he wasn't mentally prepared, because James Wade does pin double 10 and he completes a 6-2 win. Bradley Brooks, a lot of positives to take from his Euro Tour debut. An excellent win against Mark McGeaney, and he battled against Wadey, but he just could not overcome some prime wading through the opening stages of that match. James Wade, former European Darts Match Play champion, is safely through to the final day, where Wayne Jones or Nathan Aspinall awaits. Coming up next, it is Dirk van Dijvenbode who will make his typically understated entrance to the stage as he takes on the two-time world champion Adrian Lewis.
Und James Wade hat noch ein paar Geschenke für die Knirpse. Ist ja inzwischen selber Papa. Jawohl! Hey! James, once you're a father, you have a different look to see all these little boys, you know, once these flights and stuff.
Controversial, but being a father is the best thing in the world, and obviously everyone that is a father, they'll tell you that.
Satisfied with your game? My feeling was nothing special, but everything under control.
more importantly, I'm at work and I'm enjoying myself. You know, the crowd are brilliant. It's not all about family life. This is about work life, and we get on with it.
Yeah. There was this horrible trip to Australia. No, seriously, I'm always jealous when I see all these pictures. No? Get a good time there?
10-month-old baby.
I have three kids. I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
So what's your youngest child?
Sorry?
Your youngest child?
It's 9 now.
Well, you're very experienced. But for me, I'm not very experienced. So, you know, it's 24 hours on a plane with a 10-month-old baby that is absolutely perfect. But unfortunately, he doesn't feel it's the best option for him.
Okay. But his mother was with him as well.
Well, the boss, yeah.
So what's the plan for this weekend?
I'm going to have something to eat tonight. I'm lucky to be involved in tomorrow. And what will be, what will be.
Okay. Thank you very much, James. James Wade. Der ist gut gelaunt. Das